that one, Fred.
Yeah.
Nice, man.
This is my buddy Fred. He noticed some of my Do It made tackle, started asking questions about how to get started pouring. Before I knew it, he was showing up at the launch with some sweet looking football jigs.
Started doing this, I guess early December, ordered a kit, kind of pieced it together. I got a hot pot too, and they got a couple of Do It mold, and basically, you know, did a little bit of internet research, and within a matter of, I don't know, 30 or 45 minutes, I was melting lead and pouring jigs, and it's really easy to get into, and a very cost-effective way to fish, because when you get serious about your fishing, you want to throw it in there and be aggressive of where you put your jig, and not be afraid of losing $3 every single time.
Jeff was asking me why exactly I picked the particular molds that I picked. I went with versatility. Obviously, this was a cost-saving measure in the first place, so I didn't go out and buy, you know, new to the art of pouring jigs. I didn't want to go out and buy four or five different jig molds. So I went ahead and went with a football jig because it's something that I just feel comfortable using on a regular basis. Right now I'm setting up the jig and getting ready to pour it. And it's really a very easy thing to do because one of the first things I thought when I was looking at this stuff online and actually making the initial purchase and assembling all the things that I would need to build the type of jigs that I wanted, I was really concerned with, man, there's a lot of small parts. Am I going to be able to remember what hooks go into what holes? And is that going to become an issue, is remembering exactly what am I supposed to do with all these different small pieces? And it turns out when you get one of these Do-It molds, what you wind up with is, you can clearly see right there, it's written on there, 5-aught hook, 5-aught hook, 4-aught, and 3-aught hook. So there is no way to really make a blunder if you're trying to stick with the jig recipe that comes with the jig mold itself. It also, this happens to be a weedless football jig mold, and you'll notice that these pins right here are going to be the placeholders for these fiber weed guards that I'm going to epoxy in later on. But I'm going to go ahead and just lay these in here. This happens to be a 3-aught Gamagatsu hook. And let me see, put it in there. And it's real easy. You just lay it in there. You can tell these jigs have already been smoked with a candle so that they release really well. Keep your hinge well oiled so that when you go to close this bad boy, it doesn't sort of stutter or bounce on you. This is called a hot pot too. It helps to have a little bit of bone support. So anybody that's ever been given military instructions on how to fire a weapon, you know exactly what bone support is. It's basically able to stabilize the jig mold on a surface and have my hand stabilized by the surface, and I can pour and I get a real nice flow. Pops right out and you get a nice clean pour. Pop this bad boy open and see what we made. And there we got it. Four brand new out of the mold, gorgeous football jig heads. I tell you what, you start making these things and you get really all fired up, because when you look at them retail, you're sitting there going, man, I would love to have 4 or 8 or 12 of all of the same weight, but maybe in different colors or a little bit of a different formulation. When you pour your own jigs, you can have that, no problem, because I can sit here in probably 2 hours and churn out probably 40 or 50 jigs.
Here's one of Fred's football head creations being worked along the river bottom.